What we know is that obesity is becoming pandemic in Western countries, and it is also highly associated with cancer incidence and cancer development. In fact, it's predicted that obesity will overtake smoking as the number one cause of preventable cancers. So we were trying to understand how patient intrinsic factors interact with the immune system and what that means in terms of immunotherapy. Our previous data had shown that for immunotherapies, sometimes we can see increased toxicity in obese patients, and we had seen these with the strong immunostimulatory therapies like cytokine therapies and things like that. And so we wanted to follow up on those studies by looking at the toxicity of checkpoint inhibitors since they've become so clinically relevant. So our key findings are that as opposed to the immunostimulatory therapies, that we don't see increased toxicity in obese patients treated with checkpoint inhibitor therapy. But what we do see is that these therapies actually seem to work better in these patients. This is a surprising finding because we think that these patients are immunosuppressed. We really equate obesity with chronic inflammation and immune suppression. And so our initial hypothesis, our expectation was that immunotherapies would work less well in obese patients. But I think really where it makes the biggest difference is that it shows us that when we're talking about immunotherapy and we're looking for biomarkers, we've looked a lot at the tumor itself to try to find those biomarkers. But since these treatments rely so heavily on the patient's immune system, what we're seeing is that factors that really aren't factors of the tumor but are factors of the patient themselves, things like sex, age, obesity, previous exposure to infections, et cetera, that all of these things can affect the functioning of the immune system and may also be very good biomarkers for whether a patient will or will not respond to cancer immunotherapy.